I'm Michelle with Tennis Warehouse, and I'm here to explain the different parts of a shoe. Now, when we're talking about a shoe, we usually have four different parts that we refer to: the heel, the midfoot, the forefoot, and the toe. Then there's two sides to every shoe: the lateral side and then the medial side. Now let's take a look at the laces. Now the laces might seem like a pretty trivial part of your shoe, however they do come in different forms. So these laces are a little bit rounder, but there are also laces that are super flat, a little more minimal. So that's something you're gonna wanna take note of. Next we have the eyelets. Now the eyelets may also seem like a pretty trivial part of the shoe, however this can often cause tennis players rubbing right at the ankle bone. So it is something you definitely wanna take note while you're buying a shoe. Next, let's take a look at the tongue. Now there's two different ways that a tongue can be present in a shoe. They can be separate from the upper or it can be attached to the upper. When it's attached, it is gonna give you a booty-like fit, so you're gonna be really well held in there by the tongue. And then it's also worth noting the comfort levels of the tongue. This one is gonna be super plush. It's got lots of cushioning. However, there are other speed-oriented shoes that are gonna have more of a minimal tongue. Next, let's take a look at the heel counter. Now, right inside where you're gonna put your foot in, there's usually gonna be lots of plush cushioning right around your heel. And then there's usually gonna be some technology as well to hold your heel in place. Often you can't see that technology, but it's really gonna just support your heel, give you nice stability, and this is right inside that heel. Next, let's take a look at the insole. Now, most of the time, the insole is gonna be a removable part of the shoe, and then this is just gonna offer you a little more cushioning and a bit of arch support. Then from there, let's take a look at the midsole. Now, oftentimes in tennis shoes, midsoles are gonna be where the majority of the cushioning is. So you're gonna see it right here. And in tennis shoes, the majority of the cushioning is usually under your heel. So if you take a look at the deconstructed shoe, the midsole cushioning is this white part right here, and then this orange part that lifts right up. Next, let's take a look at the outsole. Now the outsole is obviously where you're making contact with the court. So this is where you're gonna have all your durability. It's also gonna be where the traction of the shoe lies. You can tell the different kinds of outsoles based on the pattern. Now a modified herringbone pattern is gonna give you great traction on any court surface, while a full herringbone pattern is gonna be best for clay courts. Also, it's worth noting that outsoles can come in one or two pieces. And then the piece that separates the two outsoles is gonna be called the shank. Now, a lot of times you can't see the shank in the technology. Sometimes you can, but most of the time you can't. And now that's gonna be the part of the shoe that's gonna keep you super stable when you're moving. Next up, let's talk about the upper of the shoe. Now, the upper is gonna be that material that surrounds your foot. So this is going to be the upper. It's usually made of a synthetic material. It can also be made of leather. It's gonna be usually nice and soft and keep you well cushioned on the court. From there, let's talk about the toe box. Now the toe box is this area where your toes fit right in here. We also call this area of the shoe the vamp, and that's just the material that's over the toe box. At the front of the shoe, we have the toe guard. Now this is just gonna be an added piece of durable material that's gonna keep you well protected against toe dragging. And that was a closer look at the different parts of a shoe. Hopefully that makes buying your next pair of tennis shoes a lot easier.